Hi YouTube, DJ Mick here. We are going to review an iPhone 4S with the new Jeffy's on 501. This is a Sprint phone and it is locked to Sprint. We will demonstrate this with the other SIM cards. So follow along, pause, fast forward, rewind, do whatever it is that you need to do, and we'll do this video uninterrupted. As in previous videos, people are like, oh, you stopped the video, oh, you switched phones. Well, just to show you, there's the model number, there's the serial number, okay? So we're always going to show you the serial number, we're always going to be using the same phone. And do bear with me as I'm not using a fancy camera, so I have to manually focus when I zoom in and out. Alright, so as you can see, we've got bars at the top. This phone is roaming because I'm in Canada. And we are going to eject that. We are going to take our Jeffy. First, actually, let's throw a Koodo SIM card in here. Go to Settings, General, Network, turn roaming off. Let's go to Wi-Fi, airplane mode, turn airplane mode on, and back off. General, about, Koodo, 11.0. And the phone reboots. Activation required. So this is where we'll put in Wi-Fi, and this is where we will get, oh come on, try and get on the Wi-Fi here. And this is where it's going to tell us that the SIM card is not compatible. Unable to join, what the heck? There we go. Okay. So, we are waiting for it to connect. Then it will allow us to select next. May take a few minutes to activate your phone. Only compatible SIM cards from supported carriers may be used. Okay. Let's eject this. Let's take our iOS 4S. Now this is the rSIM 2 Ultra S. You can see there's three different kinds here. There's that one, and that one. We will take this activated bell, insert it with the iOS 5, 4S, version 2, Ultra S. Well, if you've followed the Jeffy's previously, you know there's a pile of versions out there. So it's going to search, it says roaming, extended, roaming. Let's go to about. Still says Sprint. Let's go down to phone. Now the instructions on these do say that you do need to go into SIM applications. But I'm not getting any SIM applications here. Let's try turning off automatic. Nope, it's rebooting. Activation required. Next. SIM not valid. General network. Turn roaming off. Unable to load network list. Let's turn the data roaming on. Cellular data. Let's turn on. Let's go back in. No service. Phone. So I'm not getting any option for applications. Then the phone reboots. Activation required. Well, you can see how well that works. Let's see what the instructions are for the red guy. I wonder if it makes you go to a website. Yes, it does. Settings. Where can we make this work? Well, I'm going to pause this video, and actually no, I'll just leave it running, and I'll grab my iPad. Let's have a look at what the website says that we need to do. Safari, let's open up RGK. nse.com. Oh, come on. RGKNSE. Okay, let's see what it says. All right. Put the in the iPhone. Turn iPhone. Turn on iPhone. And then go to SIM applications. Well, let's try it from power off. Power off the phone. Assemble the SIM on the card frame, then the iPhone SIM card on top. Put them in the iPhone. Turn on iPhone, settings, phone, SIM, applications. Then you will see the message below. Enter 112 mode, auto mode, country operators, and edit code. For starters, there's no SIM applications for me. The problem won't activate your iPhone when you try to unlock the iPhone 4S. After you turn on your iPhone, before you put a GSM SIM card in the 4S, wait a couple minutes, then go to Settings, General, About. Click About. You will see the provider take off the GSM. No need to turn off the phone. The iPhone will show no SIM. Click OK. Now you can do it. So, okay. For starters, it's saying to leave this out so that it activates. Device is activated on CDMA US network. Phone. There are no SIM applications. Ah, here we go. Here we go. We still recording? Good. Bell. So, I click country operators, select your provider. Then what? So, after you select your provider, it's actually supposed to show you more options in the menu, which includes enter 112 mode, And instead, I get a rebooting phone. And I'm back to this crapola. Maybe let's try at this point, now that I can see them, let's disable the roaming. Nope. SIM applications are gone. Yay. Low battery. Country operators. So this actually says rSIM version 3.23. It is not working for me, I guess. We can move on. Let's try another sim. So that was the iOS 4S. This one here. And this is a Bell activated phone. Or SIM card, sorry. It's a little late. Okay, let's try this next one, which is this guy here. Airplane mode, on off. Let's try phone. Network. Voice roaming off. Voice roaming on. Data roaming on. Go back to phone. I want to see SIM applications here. Give it a minute there and see if that comes up. Reboot. Well, my camera just flipped off auto recording. That's lovely. Gotta reactivate this, put this in. No SIM applications. General about 501. This should be working. Well, let's try a different one. All I did right now is change the tray just to see if we have a issue with connections or alignment. So many variables, you just never know. I'm going to get another one of these Jevies out, ready to roll. Just try a different one of the same kind. Here is the same Jevy. You can call them whatever you want. Some are calling them other things. The ultimate unlock. So let's just turn the airplane mode on. Woo! On phone. SIM failure. Strange. Network. SIM failure. Let's try a different tray with that one. Wi-Fi mode. Phone. SIM pin again. No applications. So let's just give it a minute and see what happens. My guess is that it will just reboot again. And there's the reboot. So we take this out, unlock, put it back in. Searching. There's the SIM pin, but no SIM applications. That's the first step in making these work, is going into the SIM applications. And I have a feeling here it's just going to reboot again on us. Nothing. It is showing call waiting, call forwarding. So let's just give it another minute and see what happens if it goes any further than this, or reboots, or just logs on to the Sprint network again. Better unplug this in. Oh, there's the reboot. Now it'll just want to be authorized again. Okay, well, no sense messing around with that one anymore. We've tried two different SIMs, tried a different tray, and it's just not coming on. That is this package right here. Now remember, we are using iPhone 4S. It is on 5.1, so I'm not sure if there's any additional settings that we need to know. Hi, had to answer the phone. This video wasn't supposed to take this long. Now we're moving on to the red one. Same thing. Show you we're still using the same phone. There's your serial number and everything. Let's focus. Okay, you see that? Good. So we'll take the last one here and put it in. Let's see what we get. Let's go airplane mode. Give it a minute to log off the network. Turn it back on. Phone. SIM pin. So we've only seen SIM applications come up once, and that was with the very first one, this version 2. I've followed the instructions. There's no other way to get past that unlock. You have to be already in the phone. Let's turn data roaming on. Phone. Huh. The lovely reboot. Activation required. All right. Activate me. There we go. Boom. Settings. No service. General network. Data roaming on. Settings. Phone. Zero. SIM pin. That's all we got. And we know this thing's just gonna reboot again. Phone. SIM pin. No SIM applications. Phone. SIM. Wow. At this point, you know, I'm just playing. Nothing's working. I'm gonna go back to the other sim that actually gave us the sim applications. Oh, there's the reboot. Okay, well. That there was the red one. I'm telling you, this is like retarded. This is 501 and all three of these should work on this one. Phone. So this is back to the two, and we'll see what happens with it. Pin. No applications again. And it just jumps right onto the Sprint network. Well, there it is again. This is the other one, and we've got no SIM applications to proceed to the next option. I'll turn this off and reboot and just see if we get any different results. We'll go from there. So this is now turning back on after a reboot. And see what happens.
Mode 1, 2. Cancel. Well, we got SIM applications back. We're roaming. General. About. Still says Sprint. Phone. Gone. So let's reboot again. Turn it back on as soon as our sunflower goes away. And there we go. Back on. All right. Settings. Phone. SIM applications. Country. Bell. 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 Did nothing. Well, let's try one of the other chips from a reboot, just like we did with this one. Because it seemed that we weren't getting the menu, and then all of a sudden we were. Alright, 2-hour video to show you that these actually do not work. Wow. As important and as high demand that it is to unlock these iPhones, you know, this is such a headache. Okay, unlock, settings, phone, SIM applications, haha, this one works, look at that. So we're going to first choose country, we choose Bell, enter 112. Because I do believe that's what it said to do. Just press the back arrow after you choose your network. Click accept. Wait 5 seconds, then dial 112. But I've got no service. It
will not let me dial that. Slowly take the SIM card out of the iPhone, push the SIM card back in, wait for the iPhone to hang up itself. Do not disconnect yourself.
Well,
you can't even connect. It would not let me dial 112. So, should we just wait or pop that SIM out and put it back in? Searching for service provider. No service. Keep waiting. Service name will show up. Oh, we rebooted. Really? General, about, still says Sprint. And our applications are gone. It's logging on. It's gonna fail. Let's try this one more time. Power off. Power on. This particular camera I'm using only records 20 minutes at a time. Probably because it's recording to an SD card and gets hot. Especially in 1080p. So, we're waiting for this to boot up and then we'll check the menu. And yes, it's early in the morning and yes, I'm very tired. Okay, here we go. Settings. Phone. No, not even here. No applications. They didn't come this time. Well, if my phone rebooted and I was messing around with this, trying to get this to work again, all this optimized signal and untethered, updatable, auto update, auto unlock is a joke. I'm telling you guys, stay away from these. You can tell already that, you know, for starters, one, I've rebooted the phone. Oh, there's SIM applications. After how long? So we go to enter country. Auto. There is at no point you can dial 112. It just won't let you. Just sits on no service. Just for giggles, I pulled out the SIM card, slapped it back in. We're still saying Sprint. Applications are gone. Looks like it's grabbing the other network. Still nothing under applications for the SIM, and we're still reading. Oh, we've got carrier 11, which is a progress because it's not saying Sprint. SIM applications. And there we go, a nice reboot. Well, as you can see, this is not an easy or fun step for anybody to deal with. Okay, well, just rebooted and SIM applications is gone. It's searching. I'm telling you guys, these, you know, if my phone died and I had to go through this every time. Alright, that's absolutely it. I'm done. You know, I tried activating these two with the reboot. I'll give this one the benefit of the doubt and try getting it to go on the reboot. Let's shut it off. Now remember, this is the red one. So once that sunflower goes away, we will turn it back on. Once it's back on, we will go directly into phone. No apps. We'll give it a minute. A little bit of a cold, overtired, and the Jevy is not working. No service. Reboot. Nice. Well, you've seen all the variables that I've done and how this absolutely just will not take. Tried three different, more than three, because I've got two here and one here and one there, all different kinds. Yeah. No luck. So this one didn't come up with applications at all, even after a reboot. That's the red package. So, I know, just to enclose, I will just show you it's still the same phone.
There you go. So still the same phone, and we were unsuccessful with these three different Jevy's unlocks for the iPhone 4S on 501. Hope you've enjoyed this crappy review of a product that doesn't work. If you do get it to work, you're very lucky. So I'm just here at Mike's Place giving you guys a heads up. You know, the ones that we do have, hey, you know what, if you want to give it a try, we're going to have these on our website to get rid of. So you're welcome to buy them. Sales are final, but it's up to you. Don't forget to subscribe above, guys. Leave any comments below, and thumb up the video if it kind of gave you an idea what to expect with these. Peace, and God bless.